Hello students, welcome in the science class. Today we will study about the metals and non-metals, their physical and chemical properties, and we will compare their properties. First of all, metals. We will study about metals. So many forms of metal that we use in daily life, like copper, iron, silver, aluminium, gold, etc. These are metals, and these have some typical properties. Metals mostly have 1, 2, or 3 electrons in their outermost orbit or shell and form cations. On the other hand, non-metals like carbon in the form of coal, sulfur that we use in crackers, nitrogen used in fertilizers, oxygen that we breathe are non-metals. These have 4 to 8 electrons in their outermost shell or orbit, and these form anions. There are some examples of metals and non-metals. Metals are mainly steel, brass, bronze, non-metals, silicon, antimony, etc. The physical properties of metals, what will be studied in this topic? These are solid nature, hardness, high melting point, lustrous nature, malleability, ductility, conductor of heat and electricity, sonorous nature of the matters, and these properties will be studied. Now, number one property is the hardness. We know that most of the metals that we use in daily life, like iron, copper, aluminium, these are very hard, but some of the metals are very soft and these can be cut with the knife. They have low density and low melting point. Solids in nature, the metals mostly solid in nature, most of the metals are solid and except mercury, which is liquid in nature, and we as know it is used in thermometers due to its low quality, liquid quality. Third property is the lustrous nature of the metal. What is lustrous nature? Metals have a typical shining when in pure state or freshly cut. So these are lustrous. Examples are gold, silver, copper, aluminium, iron, and as we see in the diagram and in daily life, these have their particular color, particular shining, and with the help of this shining, we can identify whether it is copper, silver, iron, or gold. Malleability. What is malleability? Metals are malleable in nature. What does it mean? Means these can be beaten into thin sheets by hammering. This property is called malleability. Sheet of iron, copper, aluminium. These are widely used in daily life. We see it. These silver foil, aluminium foil. These are very fine. And gold and silver are most valuable metals, and these can be used for the making of the sheets. Ductility. Metals are ductile. What does it mean, ductile or ductility? The property due to which metals can be drawn into wires is known as ductility. And gold is the most ductile metal. Gold and silver both are used to make the jewelry, because these can be drawn into long wires by the same mass of the metal. 1 gram of gold can be drawn into a wire of about 2 kilometers in length. So we see the wires of copper, aluminium, iron, etc. Sonorous nature. What is sonorous nature? The property of the metals due to which these produce ringing sound on beating against a hard surface, like temple bell, school bell. These are made up of metals, and we hear the sound of these articles daily in our daily life. And some sonorous metals are copper, bronze, steel, aluminium, tin, silver, iron, etc. Whenever these are stricken, these produce typical sound. Metals which are soft and non-elastic or inert cannot produce the sound like mercury. These are mercury, sodium, gallium, gold, platinum, etc. Good conductor of heat. Metals are good conductor of heat. As we are seeing that, we use the articles made up of iron mostly in aluminium, copper in our kitchen, in daily life, and these are heated when we heat these articles. Heat can pass from one end to other. The best conductor of heat are silver and copper. Lead and mercury are comparatively very poor heat conductors. Now, high melting point. Metals have high melting point, but gallium has and cesium have very low melting point. These are so low melting point that these can melt if we keep them on our palm. Activities show the metals are good conductor of heat and these have high melting point. For this purpose, a apparatus is set up, that is aluminium copper wire we take and clamp it on the stand, fix a pin to the free end of the wire using wax. Through the wax we are sticking it to the rod. Now we heat the wire with the split lamp and candle or burner near the place where it is clamped. Observe after some time the free end of the wire melts. उस देर के बाद ये जो free end पर pin लगी हुई है वो melt हो जाती है और जो पिन है वैक्स मेल्ट हो जाता है और पिन पीछे गिर जाती है, जबकि मेटल पे कोई इफेक्ट नहीं पड़ता है. तो ये गुड मेटल्स आर गुड कंडक्टर ऑफ हीट एंड हैव हाई मेल्टिंग पॉइंट. मेटल्स आर गुड कंडक्टर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिसिटी एंड दैट इज व्हाई दीज आर यूज्ड इन द मेकिंग ऑफ द इलेक्ट्रिकल वायर्स. कॉपर वायर्स, एल्यूमिनियम वायर्स, सिल्वर वायर्स. सिल्वर इज द बेस्ट कंडक्टर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिसिटी, बट इट इज वेरी एक्सपेंसिव. So, in place of this, we use the copper wire and aluminium wire. Activity to show the metals are good conductor of electricity. We can see the setup, battery, bulb and clips. When we set a plate of metal in between the clips, the circuit completes and bulb glows. So, ye bulb glow karna indicate karta hai ki jo metal beech mein clips ke rakha gaya hai, वो इलेक्ट्रिसिटी को कंडक्ट कर रहा है और कंडक्शन कंप्लीट कर रहा है. फिजिकल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ नॉन मेटल्स. व्हाट आर फिजिकल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ नॉन मेटल्स? वी कैन कंपेयर दीज. दीज आर डिफरेंट फ्रॉम मेटल्स. नंबर वन, नॉन मेटल्स मे बी फाउंड इन सॉलिड, लिक्विड एंड गैस स्टेट. सल्फर, कार्बन, फॉस्फोरस, दीज आर इन सॉलिड स्टेट. एग्जाम्पल, ब्रोमिन इज लिक्विड एंड hydrogen, nitrogen, oxygen, these are gases. So these are found in all possible states, solid, liquid and gas. Non metals are non lustrous. These are not having any shining. उनमें कोई चमक नहीं होती है, रफ होते हैं, डल होते हैं. लेकिन इसमें एक आयोडीन एक्सेप्शन है जिसमें शाइनिंग होती है और लस्ट्रस है. सॉलिड मेटल्स आर सॉफ्ट एंड ब्रिटल, हैमरिंग करने पर टूट जाते हैं. लेकिन डायमंड बहुत ही हार्ड है और वो टूटता नहीं है और वो बहुत ही हार्ड मेटल है. नॉन मेटल्स हैव लो मेल्टिंग एक्सेप्ट डायमंड विच हैज वेरी हाई मेल्टिंग पॉइंट. मोस्टली नॉन मेटल्स आर हैविंग लो मेल्टिंग पॉइंट, बट डायमंड हैज वेरी हाई मेल्टिंग पॉइंट. जो मेटल नॉन मेटल्स लिक्विड स्टेट में है उनके बॉइलिंग पॉइंट काफी कम होते हैं. नॉन मेटल्स आर नॉन मेलिएबल एंड कैन नॉट बी बीटन इन टू शीट्स. वेन दीज आर बीटन, दीज टर्न इन टू पाउडर और particles. Non metals are non ductile. These cannot be drawn into wires. Non metals are poor conductor of heat and electricity, but diamond, graphite, the allotrope of carbon, is a good conductor of electricity and used in the making of electrodes. The pencil used, it is having the graphite rod inside. And it is conductor also. Non metals are non sonorous. This example indicating that the rod inside the pencil is conductor of electricity, and when it is added to the circuit, the bulb glows, indicates it is conductor of electricity, and it is the graphite used inside the pencil. Now, differences in the metals and non-metals on the basis of their physical properties. These will be compared one by one. In short, physical properties. Physical state, metals are solid except mercury. Non-metals are solid, liquid and gas or. Appearance, metals are lustrous. Non-metals are non-lustrous except iodine. Metals have low density except lithium, sodium and potassium. Non-metals have low density. Malleability, metals are malleable, non-metals are non-malleable. Ductility, metals are ductile, non-metals are non-ductile. Conduction of heat, metals are good conductor of heat, but non-metals are poor conductor. And metals are good conductor of electricity also, but non-metals are not. Melting point of metals are high, but except some cases, generally low, except diamond. So non-metals have generally low melting point. Diamond has very high melting point. Metals are sonorous in nature, produce sound on hammering. Non-metals are non-sonorous. On the other hand, these are hard. Metals are hard except lithium, sodium, potassium. Non-metals are soft except diamond. So that's all for today. Thank you.